everyone, welcome to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to share how I shave my face. Now, I started shaving around 4 to 5 months back, and I really wanted to share some tips. And if you're shaving your face for the first time, there are some things you need to know and some things you need to be careful about. So I'm going to share all that in this video. So without a further ado, let's get started. So first, let's talk about the razors to use. So I use these ones. These are by Tinkle. They come in a pack of 3, and I can't find them on Nykaa anymore. I had bought these from Nykaa, but they are not available anymore, I guess. But if I find these, I'll link them down in the description box below, and even similar razors if I can find. And there are even those Piany razors, I guess that's how you pronounce it. I'll attach the picture. I feel they are more sturdy, so you can go for that too. After these, I'm gonna buy that. So now let's start with the demo, and I'm also going to be sharing my first experience, like when I shaved for the first time, you know, what all happened. I'm gonna share that after the demo. So before you start shaving, make sure your face is cleansed properly. Now I recommend you to have some slip on your face. So you can either put a little bit moisturizer or aloe vera gel or toner or anything you like. I'm going to use a toner. I'm using this Face Shop Chia Seed Toner today. So I'm just going to apply it on my face. I'm just dabbing it. Now why I like to do this is when you shave your face dry, like when your face is completely dry, it causes a lot of tucking. I mean the razor pulls a lot, so that creates more friction and that can irritate your skin and it can cause bumps or redness. So that's why make sure to have a little bit of hydration. You can even make your face damp. Just spritz a little bit of water on your face so that it creates a little bit of slip while shaving. Now I shave my entire face with this. I even shave my upper lips and my eyebrows. I used to thread these two things first, eyebrows and upper lips, but then I learned threading at home. Then I started threading my upper lips at home, like around 2-3 years back. And only for eyebrows I used to go to salon. There was this guy near my house, he does amazing eyebrows, and I trusted only him. Like, he made my eyebrows look so good, but I think he left the place or something like that, and after that new people came and nobody could ever do my eyebrows. Like, they would always make it very thin or, you know, uneven. One will be thin, one will be thick, and I just could not take it anymore. So I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna thread it at home only. So I started threading my eyebrows at home, but it was a little bit difficult to shape, and you know, I needed somebody to hold it all the time, and you know, I just did not have anyone. And then I was like, you know what, I'm gonna use my razor only. So along with my facial hair, I use razor for my eyebrows and upper lips as well. So now let's start with the demo. So I wanted to film this video, so I haven't shaved since 2 to 3 weeks now, and the rest of my face I usually shave like once or twice a month. Eyebrows and mustache I shave as when it's needed, like it's 3 to 4 times per month. So now I'm gonna show this side. So last time I got very excited, I don't know, I overshaved, and you know, this whole part I removed. Actually, I don't like to remove this part. I like to have a little bit of hair there, otherwise it looks very weird. So usually I like to leave this hair here and just shave this part. But since last time I shaved a lot of this, as you can see, it's not looking good. So I'm just gonna let it grow. I'm gonna hide it and just do this and shave this part. So you wanna hold your blade in this position, like slanting position, and you wanna slightly, you're gonna move it slowly. If you're shaving for the first time, there's gonna be a lot of peach fuzz and dead skin on this, and that is so satisfying. You don't even know how much dead skin cells are on your face. So after shaving, a lot of it comes out. And I even like to go a little bit over here and shave my neck, because it looks weird, like my face is completely clean and my neck has hair. So I like to shave a bit of my neck too. As you can see, like, there's a lot of hair. I'm very hairy. This is how the blade is looking, and there's a lot of hair and peach fuzz. Very satisfying to see. And I shave even over here. Be careful while shaving over here. You don't want to cut off your eyebrows. And when you're shaving near your hairline, like you see a lot of hair here. So don't be overexcited and shave that too, because when it grows, it looks very weird. So don't go too much above. Just stay within the boundary. Like, don't go above this. And I like to shave my forehead. A clean forehead gives me so much confidence. Otherwise my forehead is very hairy, so I have never waxed my face and I will never do that. I don't know why would people do that. It's very bad for your skin. It pulls your skin, and I don't know why you would do that to your skin. But I would never do my I would never wax my face. I would do laser though. Like, once I get rich, I'm gonna do laser. Look at that, so much of hair and dead skin is coming off. And that is so satisfying. And after you shave, now your skin looks so much brighter and it glows. Because shaving is very good for exfoliation. You're gonna exfoliate your skin and it's gonna leave your skin like a baby. Now to shave my eyebrows. I just follow the natural shape which I have and I just shave it till there. As you can see, I'm shaving till here, and be very careful while doing this. You don't want to, you know, cut off your eyebrows and shave extra hair. And to shave below my eyebrows, I like to go in this direction and make sure, you know, to not cut your eyelashes. Be very careful while doing this. So I just like to, you know, keep my finger here and do this, so that I don't cut off my eyelashes or touch my eyes. And I like to go in this direction. And I even shave in the middle of my eyebrows, but right now I'm having a pimple over there. So I'm gonna skip that. I'll do it maybe next week. Make sure if you have some acne, don't go over it. You can shave, you know, around the rest of your face, but don't shave on your acne spot. You're gonna trigger the acne and it will be painful. And also you're gonna spread the bacteria and infection everywhere. So don't do that. Now, I know a lot of people are gonna ask, doesn't shaving cause your hair to grow back thicker, or doesn't it grow back faster? Now, obviously it's gonna grow back faster as compared to waxing or threading, because in case of waxing or threading, you're pulling the hair off the root, and in case of shaving, you're just cutting it off the surface. So that's why it's gonna grow back faster. Scientific reason is your hair gonna grow back thicker. No, your hair will not change its density, like how thick or how thin it grows back. It might appear thicker because you cut off the hair from the surface, right? So they all grow back together at the same time. So you see the hair near the roots is thick. So all of them grow at the same time. That's why they appear thicker. Whereas for waxing and threading, you pull off the hair from the roots, so they all don't grow back together. They all grow back in their own time. So that's why they look very fine. But in case of shaving, all of them grow at the same time. That's why it might appear thicker. But trust me, it's not thicker. Once it completely grows, it's gonna look normal. Shaving under the eyebrows is a bit difficult because this blade is very long. So you might opt for a smaller blade for your razor. For your eyebrows, I mean. These are not like blade sharp. They are not very sharp. So you cannot cut yourself unless you really want to. If you really shave hard, you might cut yourself. So go slowly with this. But there are very rare chances of cutting yourself if you take care properly. I even like to shave over here. You have no idea how much peach fuzz and dead skin is present on your skin. Especially if you're shaving for the first time, you're gonna see a lot of dead skin, okay? Like a lot of it. And you're gonna be very excited. Like, at least I was very excited. So seeing all that dead skin, I got so satisfied and I got, you know, too excited, and I shaved my entire face. I was just supposed to do a patch test, and always make sure to do a patch test first to see if it suits you or not. But I was supposed to do a patch test, but while doing it, I really liked the feeling, and so I started shaving over here. And a lot of peach fuzz came off, and I got more excited, and I slowly I did my entire face. So over here also I have some pimples, so I'm gonna skip this part. You know, I'm not gonna shave this part, I'll shave it later. Now I'll show how I shave my upper lips. My hair has not grown much. I also like to shave my nose. I just press my nose like this and I shave. Be careful while shaving your nose, because once I was shaving it, and you know, I have a lot of blackheads over here, so I got very excited and I overdid it. So make sure to not overdo it, because while doing it you might not feel anything, but after some time it might burn. So what I did is I started shaving over here, and the blackheads, and I wanted to get rid of the blackheads, so I overdid it. I did it a lot of times and it did not feel anything that time. It felt very smooth and stuff, and after some time it started burning, you know, because I had shaved off a lot of stuff. So make sure to not get very excited and do it within limit. Don't overdo it. And please do a patch test if you're doing it for the first time. After you're done with the razor, just disinfect it, wash it, and let it dry, and store it in a safe place. So it comes with a cap as well, so you can just store it like that, so it's secure and the dust is not gonna catch. But still store it in a drawer or something. And after you're done shaving your face, you have to put some hydration. You can either use your moisturizer or aloe vera gel. I'm going to use aloe vera gel today. This is by the face shop. This step is really important, because after you shave your face is it becomes kind of sensitive and it needs soothing. It needs hydration. So you have to provide the hydration it needs. If you don't provide any hydration, you might get razor bumps. Same goes for your body. Whenever you shave your body, make sure you're putting some kind of hydration. A lot of people get bumps on their skin whenever they shave. And if you're doing it for the first time, you are going to get bumps. I mean, that's very normal. If you don't get, then that's great. But if you do get, that's very normal. Unless it's a lot and it's abnormal and it's not at all looking good, then you might want to, you know, stop shaving. That means it's not suiting you. But if you have little bit of bumps, that's completely normal. Even I got bumps for the first few times when I started shaving. That's because our skin is not used to shaving, so that's why it reacts like that. But that's completely normal. I don't get bumps anymore after shaving, so your skin gets used to that. So I have a thick layer of it all over my face. This is very calming and soothing for your skin. If you are somebody who has a lot of hormonal hair growth, like if you have PCOD and if you have very thick hair growth, then I'm not sure if you should shave, because your hair growth is very thick. So you might want to do it very regularly, like you might want to do it every single day, and if you can commit to that, then you can. But you should definitely check with your dermatologist or a doctor. But it's not needed to shave your entire face with this. If you have slight peach fuzz here and there, you can get rid of that. It's not needed that you need to remove the entire thing, and there's no shame in shaving your face. Everybody shaves their face, so don't believe like only men should do it and stuff. Nothing like that. Yeah, we are in 2019, almost 2020. Nothing like this exists anymore, or should exist. So there are a lot of advantages in shaving your face. The number one reason why I like shaving my face is the makeup application. The makeup application is so smooth and the makeup looks flawless, okay? Like when you have hairless skin, the foundation and everything is gonna be so smooth, and it's gonna blend like heaven, and it's gonna look good as well. So when you have peach fuzz or little bit hair, and your foundation sticks on that, so your makeup does not look very smooth. It might look cakey, but if you have you know, no hair, it looks very beautiful. Especially your highlight, like on this section, if you remove the peach fuzz over here, your highlight is gonna look so smooth. So that's the number one reason why I love shaving my face. The second reason is that it makes my skin look so clear and so glowy. Whenever I don't shave my face, it kind of looks dull. But whenever I shave my face, first of all, it's exfoliating your skin. So obviously, it's gonna make your skin brighter because you're getting rid of all the dead skin cells and whatever is not required on your face. And third thing is, feels very satisfying. When you shave your face and you see a lot of dead skin cells getting removed, it's very, very satisfying. I mean, at least for me. And the fourth point is your skin feels very smooth. I think I said it already, but doesn't matter. There are a lot of benefits in shaving your face, but there are disadvantages as well. So if you have, you know, any skin disease or if your skin is very sensitive, it might not work for you. So make sure to do a patch test or just consult your doctor. But it works amazing for me. It might work amazing for you as well. It might not work amazing for you. So it really depends. So make sure to do a patch test first. And if you have shaved just now, like especially if you're just starting out, after you shave your face, your skin becomes a little bit more sensitive. So, you know, wait for a few hours before you put makeup and stuff. And also don't directly go out in the sun. Preferably do it on a holiday or something if you're just gonna be sitting at home the whole day. Whenever you exfoliate your skin, unless it's very mild exfoliation, you need to give your skin a little break. Otherwise, you know, it might burn and stuff. So again, that depends on the type of skin you have. If you have very sensitive skin, you need to be extra careful. So yeah, so these were all the things I wanted to share about shaving your face. If you still have any more doubts or queries, please leave them down in the comments down below. I would love to help you. And also I'll link down all the products I used in the description box below so you can check it out. So that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. And please share this video with your friends and family and help them as well. And also please subscribe to my channel. I upload new videos every Saturday. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.